I think I'm gonna throw up, big time. Everybody brace for impact. I think I have snapped completely. Gloves off. Hey guys. Harry Thomas here, and brace yourselves for my review. Oh, if you could even call this a review, no. I will not be generous to this nostalgia bait, money-stealing shit. So this is a extreme rant on Despicable Me 4. Illumination have made 4 of these. Oh. God help us. Like, the first Despicable Me story is the only good one. Why can't they get the sequels right? The sequels are freaking cursed. So, Despicable Me 4, directors by Chris Renata and Patrick Delage, and is the 4th installment in the Despicable Me franchise. Well, technically 7th if you count the Minions movies, but the 4th in the Despicable Me quad trilogy, because we all wanted this to make it to 4, am I right? Am I right? Nope, I'm just hearing a bunch of crickets in the audience. Oh, I thought so. So, Despicable Me 4 tells the story, such as there is one, of... Gru and Margot and the girls, Agnes, Edith and Poppy, and now him and Margot have a baby son, Gru Jr. Oh, really original there, Illumination. Everything seems happy-go-lucky until Maxine, Gru's nemesis, breaks out of jail and wants revenge. So Gru and his family need to go into hiding and change their identity and home. Wait one fucking second. The Simpsons already did this plot in Cape Fear when Sideshow Bob returned to get his revenge on Bart. Maxine has transformed himself into a cockroach and has a girlfriend. He plots to steal Gru's son to raise him as his sidekick, and the girls are going off on their own subplots that lead to fuck all, and the Minions do their usual wacky shit, which is not fucking funny anymore, and screw it, that is it. Despicable Me 4 fucking sucks. It is a Goliath steaming pile of yellow minion shit, fresh from the minion's anus. It has now dethroned Minions Fall of Gru as Illumination's worst piece of shit they have ever released. It is the constipation of Illumination. Like, I mean, if you enjoy Despicable Me 4 more than the third film, or if you don't think it's the worst in the franchise, opinion respected. I am not the target audience in any way, shape or form, but if you are the target audience, or if you are a lover of the Despicable Me sequels, you may get some fun out of this. But as somebody who doesn't think any of the Despicable Me sequels after the first have been a good, this was a painful chore to get through. This would have to be the second worst movie I have seen in 2024, second only to Megamind versus the Doom Shisicate. I mean, I'd even put Kung Fu Panda 4 slightly above this, but congratulations, 2024. You now have not one, but two underwhelming fourth installments in a franchise. So as you can guess, sir, I don't have any fucking positives for Despicable Me 4. I am ready to rip it apart, scene from scene, as the animation is the exact same as the other Despicable Me movies, and this one is coming 14 years after the original, and no improvement with the animation quality. Illumination are doing the exact same thing. The animation is fucking nothing, and I mean, if you want gorgeous animation, watch Inside Out 2. In fact, watch Inside Out 2 over this on all accounts, because you and your children will get lots of valuable life lessons from it. You won't get any of that with Despicable Me 4. This is the easiest to market and most pandering movie to kids that I have seen all year. It is how not to make animation sequels. I mean, and I know you're thinking, Harry, you were generous to Ice Age 4 and Shrek 4. How come you have a problem with Despicable Me 4? Because Ice Age 4 was actually funny, and Shrek 4 at least had some intelligence to it, and some heart. And in fact, even Toy Story 4 had some heart. Despicable Me 4 is a tired old turd, and the plot and the gags are completely and utterly derivative and ripping off other and better properties, like how I already mentioned how the plot rips off The Simpsons' Cape Fear. But Gru Jr., Gru and Margot's baby son, he is the most insufferable baby character I have seen in a movie in so long. And he is Jack-Jack done bad. And that moment when he wrestles a honey badger, well, complete and utter copy of Jack-Jack versus the Raccoon from Incredibles 2. Inferior in every conceivable way. And that's another thing. They played the trailer in the cinema for this way too many times. And Maxine LeBlanc wanting to turn Groom Jr. against his father. Like, that's ripping off what Syndrome wanted to do with Jack-Jack in the first Incredibles. Like, I'm like, stop trying to be the Incredibles Despicable Me 4. Be your own movie. Not that these are sorry excuses for screenwriters gave a shit. I could smell no effort in this script. And the minions, even though they have brand new minion designs with the huger supersized minions that can swallow the regular-sized minions whole. The minions are nothing new. Their storyline does not lead anywhere. And the storylines with the girls, Edith, Agnes and Poppy, going off to school, where does it lead to? Nothing. It is never resolved. I kid you not. So this movie is overcrowded with subplots. Like, four different storylines going on at once. Gru's storyline in this is boring as hell. Like, he's seeing him being a father is completely and lazily played for laughs. No heart to it. Nothing comes close to that Three Little Kittens story scene in the first film, which is still my favourite scene in the Despicable Me franchise. And him saying to the girls, Why can't you be more like your sister? She lies all the time. She's lying right now, beautifully, I might add. I'm a like, wow, what an asshole forcing his girls to be the same. I mean, he has not changed for the better 4 movies in. And Maxine, the main antagonist, what the fuck did they do to him? Like, they made him into a living hybrid human cockroach. It is disgusting. It is grotesque. And how on earth is his girlfriend attracted to him in that body? Does she want to sleep with a cockroach? Ew. And when he transforms a Groot Jr. into a mini cockroach, that is borderline disturbing. And this is supposed to be a family movie. And it was so predictable, I knew what it was going to lead to. It was going to lead to a cheesy as fuck and a corny dance number with all the villains in from the franchise in prison breaking into song to a ghastly modern pop song, and that's exactly how it's concluded. So please, people, save yourself the agony. Please save your money on Deadpool and Wolverine this July instead. Please avoid Despicable Me 4 the plague, and please let Despicable Me 4 bomb. So that's Illumination finally be done with Despicable Me, and we'll work on better things to improve instead. And Will Ferrell, I'm disappointed in you, man. I mean, I adored you as the CEO at Mattel and Barbie last year, but to go from Barbie to this?
I give Despicable Me 4 0 stars out of 5. Fuck this movie.
Ooh. Ah. Ooh. God. 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 Ah. Oh, I'm gonna need to take a yoga class just to let go of my raw hatred for Despicable Me 4, guys. Well, Illumination, it's not likely you're gonna escape my rant playlist with Minions 3 in 3 years time, is it? You've shot yourselves in the foot. I love you guys. Thank you for watching. I hope you guys enjoyed this extreme rant. And what are your thoughts on Despicable Me 4? And do you feel it's time for this franchise to die already? Please comment and let me know. Please like this video and subscribe. Please follow on Twitter and Instagram. And I'll see you next time. And remember, movies are us. Bye, guys.